one thing that Bosnia and Herzegovina, second in Europe, second state in Europe in terms of volume migration.
I have to say here something. Can you stop the video? Did not migrate from Mecca till they kicked him out.
Yes.
They fighted him out.
Yeah.
Then he migrated to. But always he used to remember Mecca.
He stayed loyal.
And he stayed loyal to Mecca, even though Mecca did not. And he couldn't go back to Mecca in the end, because he found that the Medina people, they helped him a lot and they supported him. So he stayed till the end of his life. But he always say that, oh Mecca, I say, and even I will come to tears now, you know, if your people did not kick me out, I would not let you. Okay? Even though Mecca is nothing, Mecca is, you know, compared to Medina, Medina is more beautiful than Mecca. Okay, it's open space, greener, more. Mecca is between
mountains.
Two mountains, three mountains.
Dr. Mohamed, I can understand that when I was in Italy, there is my colleague on the work that speak something like, this is my country, I'm commanding here, to provoke me. But I can't understand that I here in Bihać can heard that something like, you are not originally from this town. I don't think that it's important.
Okay.
Important that now I'm loyal to Bihać.
True.
As I was 25 years old, loyal to my country. This is my country.
True.
I want to feel free in Mostar, in Banja Luka.
Yeah. Well, I was reading about Bihać through internet because I wanted to understand more what's happening here. And because for us, and this is maybe the first place, we're dedicating time. And we started only in August, always I tell my sisters. And for 1 year we did success story, alhamdulillah. But really, we need to understand what is the mindset of here is still, it's village based. It's more of villagers that kind. And lots of people, they believe in, there is this mindset. This is our village.
Yes.
And why these people come from this area, even though they are from, what is it, Santi Mosque or from Sardin and so on, okay? And this is our mindset that we need to change again. This is through education, curriculum. So look for the change factors. Look for the change factors that you might mitigate. Now, you cannot change the system, but you can mitigate the system. You can play with the system. So you go around the system, don't fit the system, go around the system. For, as I give an example, Amina cannot graduate unless she take a course. Or, now she can graduate without her, but I need to convince Amina that she take a course. Then I need to convince Amina that she become a trainer, okay? And maybe she make MGO for this, okay? And so on, okay? So that's maybe that.
Then we found that according to the source of UNDP, for about 39% of the total population, which means Muslims, Serbs, Croats, are migrated from, this is about 1 million and a half, which is a lot of people.
Okay.
A lot of people.
And here I did not cover this, but this is, you need to put it in your first table, the process of, if we go back to this. I'm interrupting you,
no.
I'm just so that you support it, what you write here. Because if you don't write here anything, you cannot solve all of it, right? This is the secret where you start, okay? So if we go to this, and we are having different type of migration, right? We said. So those who migrated, and now already migrated, okay? Is there anything in the system that tells them to come back to Bihać? Okay, let's say we are having now 20% of our population or Una Sana Canton, okay? They are anywhere outside, okay? Is there anything in the system that is making them attraction? For example, I am from Una Sana Canton or from Bosnia, okay? Is there anything that tells me if you are Bosnian and you are an investor, I will give you better maybe facilities than person who's coming from Bahrain? Because you are supposed to have this person more important than this person. If this person is buying same as this person, then what is the use for him? He said that I'm not appreciated by my country. Okay. So maybe you need to also measure this thing. Whoever they migrated now, these 20%, can I play with mitigating, bringing them back, encouraging them by some means? Okay. Is there any society, NGO, that handle those that are migrated to here? And usually in Egypt and Jordan and these countries, Tunisia, they are having many societies, NGOs, that specialize only for those in France, those in so in Italy, whatever, okay? Maybe this is again something that you need to measure and see if the, if you can link or collaborate. You cannot open society now. What you can do, you can collaborate with societies there. For example, there might be a club for Bosnian club, maybe in France, for example. So I'll go and do a training for Bosnian club. And this is where when they evaluate your project, the jury, they would see that you are trying to do something that hits where the sustainability. Because already you are starting to go abroad. You did not only analyze the problem here, or put something in the system. You go to those people who are already there, and you started to do train the trainer program. Okay, what is now happening in Bosnia today, and how much you can do to help us back? Okay, after they are good role model and successful, why don't you come back and teach in the school during summer? Okay, so there is lots of ideas that you can bring once you see the partners and potential. And these are opportunities. What I'm doing with you now is just opening the opportunities you can tackle in your world.
Okay. You talk about earlier about statistic official census results, which is interesting for us. And we evaluated population by age, for example, from 20s, 25, 30, and so on. For example, pupils and students in the city of Bihać, 5,000. This is maybe interesting for us to see in another 2 or 3 years how much of them maybe will go for abroad for studying. For study and so on. Tendency of immigration, economic, political reasons, war and consequences of war, relationship between migration and European perspective of Bosnia and Herzegovina, for example, mobility for study and for work, which is very interesting for our canton, because a lot of our citizens from this canton had had documents, for example, Croatian passports, which is in some way already now European citizens.
Yes, yes.
I know all of our friends, which is we deal with in the university of Croatia. What is interesting from the
statistic that does not cover the below 20? I've seen that you started from 20.
Yes.
Yeah, are they thinking that there is no problem below 20 of migration? Are there young migrators like 15, 18 years old that they are migrating working as labor or no problem?
No, just they go with their family, full family.
Just go with full family.
Okay.
This is now a problem. And
so this is again another one in the process.
Yes.
So another one in the process is migrated, but they never nobody communicated. Okay.
Yes.
Never being communicated by system. Okay.
Yes.
And there is a whole family, right? It's another one.
Okay.
Because the possibility for someone who goes without family to come back, it's more than with someone who goes with his whole family planning not to come back.
Right. And. What will happen with this population in 30, 40 years?
Yes.
There will be an old population?
Yes, the second generation.
Second generation.
Third generation.
Who will work if there is no young healthy person which can generate
and ambitious new, yes
and
we know that the economy is stabilized by youth not by yes.
And contribution for the pension
yes.
funds
yes
and there is something that is starting to talk about now in our
society or
yes, yes.
But we need to do our own survey and even when you do the survey maybe take certain points now okay and we'll give you this video anyway is that you check with those from for example 13 to 18 years old or below 20 whatever okay
yes.
maybe okay are they thinking of migrating now or when they graduate if it is increasing for example if those they're saying no we want to migrate now we want to study in Germany for example because there's free universities also in Germany
yes
then this is a problem
yes
it's even more problem because once they study there usually you know good companies Siemens and or these Philips and so on they'll go and target them inside the university they tell them come and work here
and there is especially in this specific moment there is a sector so not only education but for example healthy sector that remain out of technician nurses doctors they go abroad
yes.
With theoretically they have problems because a lot of young people and young students want slowly to go educated for those
interesting and this is very good try to be we use what we call PROC especially for complex problems we use technique called visual management okay visual management and try to draw whatever you say for example you can say that this maybe could say the layers of society right okay and we are having this layer of society which is maybe here like village people okay or low labor okay and so on and then middle class okay and then we are having the top
engineers
doctors, professionals okay
professionals
yes. whatever okay
yes
okay.
So these are now if you are having drain in here problem okay or if we are having a drain in here there is a problem If we're having them here, then we'll solve the problem differently. So you need to draw this and say, for example, this, we found that this is maybe taking 20%. This is 10%, for example. Okay, this is 50%. Okay, if this is 50%, I don't have a problem here.
Yes.
Okay, my problem now is here and here. All of them is a problem, but sorry, not a problem, but my mitigation factor is different than here and here. Because my investment in here is less, and the governments always feel the pinch from the investment. We try to يعني show in, maybe it will be here or something like this or it is increasing here maybe I believe in it's maybe not here I believe it is today its majority is here but show that there is increase that like these students who are really their families they work hard and so on once they graduate they migrate this means and it's increasing this is where the government will start to feel and this will show your story because remember if you want to present a study for the whole world and how much this is important because no country will allow this is security problem okay, okay even the security but this is more security this you are taking my bread and butter okay I will fight with you on my bread and butter because you are taking my most valuable asset it's more important than even una rada
unemployment of young people
yes.
is become a cause of migration and
but when you say young people which age do you manage to categorize them
age from 20-21
you're tired you can just
a little
take some time and relax
and
I mean, I can put it here, down, like this.
It is a good one. what we found interesting that it become a topic for the conversation, something like development for survival and for stay.
Okay. Can I interrupt here again?
Yes.
And here I want just to help you in doing techniques, because inspiration
yes.
economy is about using certain techniques to inspire whether the targeted project beneficiaries, okay, project beneficiaries, or to inspire the whole world, okay?
Mm-hmm.
okay, because the whole world face this problem directly or indirectly. Now, you know, today the world is open, so
yes.
many people is migrating. What you need to do, you remember, we have three levels of solving a problem. Okay? The first level is called estimation. Okay? Second level is called forecasting. Okay? Third level is called intelligence. What you want to do now, the government was trying to do, is trying to do estimation. You want to raise the level of your solving the problem and ability of forecasting how you can solve a problem. And there is a level of intelligence. This means you need to move from codifying the problem. Now you need to do, first of all, codification of the problem. Codification means that which type of migration and which year, which age. So age of migration. This is codification. Okay? Is it in 18 to 20? Is it in 22? Okay. Then from, again, which... what is their profession? What is their level in the society? Is it professionals, like we spoken about, middle
yes,
class and so on?
Yes,
okay?
yes.
Or is it from Bihaj more? So this is called codification, is called classification. Okay, statistics, if you bring two inputs or three inputs variables, you call it classification of data. Okay? So it is not only from age 18 to 20, it is those that is maybe from Sansi Mosque or Sazin, which is their income is about from 10,000 to 20,000 euro, blah blah blah. These are the ones that's migrating now. This is classification. Okay. So that you come to the level of classification and then stratification. Stratification means you start to solve the problem specific with a specific group. You cannot solve the problem with all the groups. But you specify your project from, for example, age 18 to 20.
Yes.
I want to minimize because they are the highest risk and they are the most valuable. I will reduce. Yeah. And whatever I'm saying to you, I know it's difficult and too many information I'm giving
yes.
now.
Yes.
See the video and I'll give it to Amina to send it to our through drive or something.
Okay.
I'll put it to YouTube. But try to analyze what I'm saying. Yeah, now this is where you can increase your ability of solving the problem.
It is interesting that I found that in September. Our Chamber of Commerce it will organize a fair which main topic will be development for survival and for stay of young people, particularly young people, to try to understand the problem and to arrive to decision and solution regarding migration.
When is that?
That will be in September, so-called EcoBIS 2016.
Yeah, I mean, which date? What is the date? We might work with them on that through your team.
I don't know.
Okay.
Specific
okay.
date.
Okay.
But
I mean, you can go and present your data,
yes.
your study,
yes,
and maybe
yes.
even Amina can go and do that. So this,
yes.
again, spreading is a good area where you spread your message.
Main topic, not my topic, main topic, Dr. Mohammed, will be sustainable survival or stay. Stop the outflow of young people abroad, stay and self-employment by starting own businesses.
Okay.
Top team of the fair will be that, to create a network of incubators for the development of startup.
Okay.
It will be difficult, but
yes. No, but, and this is, by the way, long-term solution. All the governments,
yes,
they do now incubators. And we,
yes,
this is why I brought UNIDO. No?
Yes.
UNIDO is to build up these incubators and help you. Okay.
But I think that there can be our partner.
Yes.
Yes.
We can advise them. And
yes.
Yes.
As our partner. Yes. I think
and that... And they can invite them to the forum.
I
second one of the things we need to talk.
One
about
of the questions
things
of that will be, I thought to ask you.
Yeah, yes.
Them as a partner,
yeah,
maybe Ministry of Education,
education, yes,
with our two teams.
Yes.
Maybe this office of Diaspora Ditsazin, maybe.
Yes.
And I want to, to tell you about Association of Students, which
okay
is a student of secondary school, not university.
Okay, excellent.
There is a very active group of them in Ditsazin.
Okay, excellent.
Maybe not if we don't...
can invite them to attend, yes?
Yes,
now,
to attend.
We are looking for, oh, yes.
And maybe
free
in the second phase
in
of
any,
the project.
Anyone that is helping us,
okay,
registration, try to make it free. So that encourage more people to come from this.
I thought maybe one of those of them can be our partners.
Yes.
Because I in these 2 months,
yes,
I noticed that they are active.
Excellent.
And
already you contacted them, or you want to...
Yes. My student leader had the connections with them.
Okay.
And this...
Make sure your students, they are with you, the team members, they see the video, so that they make sure,
okay,
they understand what you have been talking about.
Okay. And then, in the end, we thought maybe to bring experience, best practices of those people who migrate and
come back.
And invest their own money
In the canton.
In the canton, yes.
Or in the Bosnia. Yes.
Or in the Bosnia, yes. And this is
excellent.
Much or more.
Excellent. So now what is so now we are we need to do the table. So what's our action plan? So that let's start to make conclusion. Okay, I suggest the action plan would be a pro. Is the number one is that we make the table. We try to work on the table of risk management program that we talked about. You cannot answer everything, so actually some of the answer will come from point two, which is you set up now. We said you did indicators very good, okay? Now we go to measures. Measures means you need to do interviews, selected interviews, right? With the good examples or the ones that is migrating.
Yes.
And you need to do a questionnaire, okay? Questionnaire, I suggest also maybe you can sit down or see the, I'm not sure, did you see the questionnaire of...
yes, I saw.
I mean, Arabic.
Yes, yes.
So their questionnaire is... you can build the same questionnaire, very simple, one page.
Okay.
Just starting up. We'll call it questionnaire number one, because you'll do another one after the forum.
Okay. This question, can I activate it in the days of forum?
No.
Or before?
No,
before. You need to bring it to the forum. You need to bring it to the forum, because even the ones who's coming, our experts, coming from Bahrain or wherever,
they
want to see the data to start helping you,
okay,
and other teams, they can use it also.
Okay.
So you need to inspire people. In, they are coming, but they are seeing that they can do something about it. Okay, then we'll go for number three. Is that now using this and this to come with number three? So number three will be solving. Will come to what we call opportunities for our project. what are the opportunities we can tackle in order to bring inshallah success story. I feel, see, just moving the glass from here to here will make it successful. Because nobody has moved the glass from here to here.
Yes.
In this way. Yes, the government is moving the glass from here to here, but with resources. They're putting, they want to put money, they want fund from the European Union, and so on. But you are saying, no, I can move this glass from here without resources. Just with using my mindset, my way of thinking. This is maybe the success. And all the best, inshallah.